Breaking $1 billion, that is truly an inflection point. Is that telling us something about the movies in general, or is this telling us something about this movie in particular?
I think it's telling us more about this movie in particular. You see, tons of movies have come out, but they haven't come out to this huge momentum the way that you've seen with Spider-Man. And it's especially notable, Becky, because Spider-Man didn't even debut in China, which is typically where Marvel films get huge audiences. I think what this says about the box office in general is that people are willing to go to theaters despite COVID, despite the Omicron rise, if it's the right movie. And Spider-Man not only got critical acclaim and great reviews, but it also really created a cinematic experience, fandom, that we haven't seen for any other films, including many other Marvel films throughout the pandemic.
Joanne, maybe proof in the pudding is just what we've seen with West Side Story. That's now been out in the theaters for 3 weeks, and it's taken in less than $37 million when it had $100 million, I should say, in terms of that budget for that film. What happened? That film's gotten great reviews.
It's gotten great reviews, and actually, I had actually seen it at a screening. This is before Omicron popped up, and the theater was full. People loved it. We were planning to even take our own family as our Christmas movie, which we do every year, to see West Side Story. And we looked at the variant, and then we looked at people buying tickets, and we said, never mind. And I think, obviously, there are millions and millions of people like that. I do think, though, my concern, Becky, is that the movie theaters, the studios, are now going to be looking at this and saying, is there a market for grown-up movies? And I think that
Right.
is, yeah, no, I think this is problematic. I mean, look at what's on the schedule for next year. You've got it's great for Disney, which has a bunch of Marvel, additional Marvel movies coming out. I think there's a Doctor Strange, and there's a couple of Batmans. Well, actually, a Black Panther, I think, from the Marvel Universe, Thor. And then you look at the other films that are getting all the attention for next year. And it's, again, it's these sort of remakes or sequels, Indiana Jones, Top Gun, Avatar, Batman, Jurassic Park. So I do think that there's sort of a realignment going on, and it'll be very interesting. And I would hope that the studios don't look at what's happening right now and say, well, there's no more market for grown-up films.